You want it, let's do it. Ride it, my pony. My saddle is waiting. Come and jump on it.
Thank you so much for this question. I get this all the time. People want to know, well, isn't there a point at which you are too overweight and you do need to lose weight for your health? To which I say, no, and here's why. It boils down to the fact that weight is not a behavior. Moving your body, eating healthy foods like fiber-rich foods and vegetables, these are health-promoting behaviors and can decrease things like risk of mortality, etc., without weight loss being the goal. Essentially, you don't have to lose weight in order to be healthier. Then you have to look at weight stigma. Yes, it exists in the medical field. The first thing is that people who live in larger bodies are less likely to go to the doctor because guess what? They're constantly being told to lose weight and it's very uncomfortable for them. So that alone leads to negative health outcomes. It's also really lazy medical advice. There's been many studies to show that joint pain in people with larger bodies has nothing to do with the weight. But again, it's an easy scapegoat. Comment below if you want me to break down some studies for you. It's way too much information to post in 1 minute.
Y'all, that comment said, when you're morbidly obese and experiencing a number of health conditions, does she recommend losing weight? And she's just being obtuse here for the sake of this content. Anyone who's seen even one episode of My 600 Pound Life or 1000 Pound Sisters knows that there's a point when your weight is directly what's affecting your health and your quality of life. Your weight is the reason you can't shower and reach parts of your body. Your weight is the reason you can't leave your house and travel in a vehicle normally. Your weight's the reason that you can't walk to the mailbox without it being a stressful, traumatic event. This is just BS.
I'm in so much pain. I can't believe I allowed myself to get this big. I'm in so much pain. I'm pushing myself to go to work every day, but I can't take it.
So the girl from those two videos has gained a significant amount of weight from the second video to the first one, and she's really depressed about it. There's no content I could find on her page where she was glorifying her body type, glorifying obesity, or encouraging others to try to achieve it. I just wanted to include this basically as a direct juxtaposition to that last TikTok. I really don't think that lady would say exactly what she said to her audience, to this girl. Do you?
Number one, yes, I'm pretty. Thank you for acknowledging. Number two, you do not have to identify with a marginalized group in order to support that community, right? Like, I'm using my straight size privilege to speak on topics of fat phobia that fat people get body shamed for and told that they're making excuses. Number three, unlearning anti-fat biases is crucial for most people in ED recovery, and that's what my page is about. So if you don't like it, bye.
Okay, hot take, thinness is not a privilege. Thinness requires maintenance, privileges require nothing. I am a twin, and when my twin and I lived in the same house, ate the same food, and exercised about the same, we also weighed about the same. We're adults now, we exercise very different amounts and eat very different types of foods, and she has put on an amount of weight that she is not comfortable with and is actively trying to reverse.
Does anyone even like Barbies anymore? Am I even relevant?
Hey, skinny people,
Please find the strength to stop being insufferable for like 2 seconds. Thanks.
No.
No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, that's just rude and unnecessary. Like, that girl wasn't being hateful towards fat people or anything. She was just questioning her relevance in a world where apparently street-sized bodies are out.
Thank you for coming to my TED Talk, to my TED Talk.
Imagine telling someone in a wheelchair who's gained some extra weight and wants to lose it that body positivity isn't for them. Are you kidding me? I cannot figure out what is to be gained by gatekeeping this movement in this way. It just seems like bitterness, like extreme bitterness.
Thank you for coming to my TED Talk, to my TED Talk.
Okay, so this definitely reads as bitter and projection, like that's how he feels about himself. The reason that this specific content affects me, bothers me, is because I dislike any time people are spreading misinformation on such a large scale when it is directly consequential to people's lives. If we're gonna use social media to try to educate and raise awareness, then I'm gonna use my voice to combat those voices.
Girl, I got bad news for you.
In her TikTok, she basically said, like, I'm trying to lose weight because I don't want to be depressed like fat anymore. But the thing is, honey, you're gonna lose the weight and you're still gonna have bad body image. I've been there. I lost like 60 pounds, but it was never enough. I had to be skinnier. I empathize with you because I've been in your situation, but saying you're a proud fat phobe, like what? Girl, get off the internet. You about to get canceled.
So I don't know about you, but this looks a lot like unsolicited health advice to me. But I guess it's okay because it's not rooted in fat phobia, whatever that means. Either way, clearly this girl has decided that her weight loss was contributing to her feeling worse about herself. And it seems like she framed the word fatphobic really specifically to her, but somehow this other girl is taking it as an attack on all fat people. I think that's part of the problem with the word fatphobia. Like, what does it even mean? I really want to understand the many shades of the definitions of this word.
I think a lot of us forget that fatphobia is trauma for fat people. If you were fat and are now skinny, if you were fat, got skinny, and are fat now, if you're generally fat and haven't experienced fatphobia, you have experienced a lot of trauma. I was just getting myself dinner and I got 3 sets of appetizer because I might eat one tomorrow. I might eat all of them right now and I forget that that's okay. I forget that that's okay. And they asked me how many utensils and I said 1 and I was like, well, I have another set at home because I feel sad and sorry for taking up space. Because I remember comments and when people are like, oh, you only need 1 set. I already knew that. I don't even know why. Like, just fatphobic fucking trauma. And I think people forget that when I say fat phobia is trauma and I stop you and I'm like, hey, what you're saying is insensitive. Can you please stop? I think we forget fat phobia is trauma. We always are like, I don't really care. Whatever. When I say it's trauma, I mean it's trauma.
Okay, so here's the deal. You could be in that exact same situation as a thin person picking up your takeout food and walk out the restaurant and hear the hostesses talking about what you're wearing or the way your hair looks or how you did your makeup. Whatever it might be, other people can always find something to make fun of you about. It's not a specific experience to fat people. I experience insecurity when I interact with strangers all the time. It's just a normal feeling and I am not comfortable calling it trauma. I'm truly not.
What happened?
It was the most traumatic experience of my life.